On December 22nd, 2023, the Uganda Revenue Authority issued a circular restricting warehousing of goods including wheat grain, flavors for soft drinks, tiles, marble and granite, with effect from January 1st, 2024. This meant that importers of the listed goods had to start clearing their goods at the first port of entry into the East African Community.
They have never notified us again, neither did they take an initiative to come and meet the traders down. So we are here by calling the URA or any organization that is implementing all this to come down and explain to the last person down who imports, because these importers are low importers. Actually, they don't have enough money. Most of them, they bring things and they get loans when their things reach the bonded warehouses here.
However, this has not gone well with hardware importers in Kampala who are claiming losses since the new order took effect. Under their umbrella body, Nakasero Hardware Business Association, they have decried the new policy, saying that it has escalated the cost of importation as they have to incur insurance fees.
This issue of payment of taxes while the goods have just arrived in Mombasa is really giving us a heartache or a headache. Surely we all understand and appreciate the role of the business community when it comes to sustaining the economy of this country. However, not many Ugandans can afford to work using their own money. Most of them are using body money.
They have called upon Uganda Revenue Authority to reverse the policy, saying it's better to clear goods upon arrival instead of clearing them from Mombasa and get problems on the way, including accidents and theft.
No trader can afford it, because to pay tax, once a container gets any accident, URA doesn't want to know. And most of the containers are being stolen even on the road, and URA doesn't bother as long as you have paid their taxes. For them, what they mind is about tax, but they don't mind about how this person is going to survive tomorrow when his container is crushed on the road.
This has been coming for long. They started with fuel, then grain bulk and others which fall into that category. That is wheat and other items which are brought into the country in bulk. We are having over 20 items already on the list. But all people, all of them, apart from fuel dealers and grain bulk, all of them cannot afford, cannot manage to pay taxes while goods are still in Mombasa.
Many of them, who are small importers, argue that they have always been using the period which the container spends on the way from Mombasa to mobilize clearing fees, which is now becoming difficult.
I wish they could say that now no importing tiles to Uganda. That's what we can understand, that they have not told us not to import.
We import mixed goods, though there are tiles in, and they are fragile goods. So we feel it's not right if they tell us to pay from Mombasa, because they are fragile. If they open your container from Malaba, sometimes they cannot put back the things the way they are, so we'll get a lot of brokerages and will not have anyone to pay for us.
Today they held a meeting and resolved to seek an audience of URA, but also petition Parliament for intervention.
We are going to write to Parliament. We are going to storm in case our problems are not looked at. We shall.
This is first borrowing. URA is forcing Ugandans, arm twisting people to pay their taxes while they are still in Mombasa. In this case, by implication, they are forcing Ugandans, or they are forcing importers, to lend them money.
However, the Uganda Revenue Authority says they consulted all stakeholders in May last year and they agreed with importers to delay implementation of the policy.
We actually met the traders in May. When we're talking about these traders, we met them in May, and there was a serious engagement on this government directive on how best we can manage some of these imports. So the traders agreed, and they pleaded that we should wait the implementation up to 31st December.
Adrian Motebi, the acting assistant public relations officer of Uganda Revenue Authority, explains what informed the decision to ban warehousing of tiles, marble and granite.
So we want to improve, and in the process of improving and streamlining our warehousing, there are certain items we are no longer warehousing. Now, for example, the tiles, we agree that they are not supposed to be warehoused now. If someone imports, they should be in position to pay at the port. So that, of course, the government also gets money early, other than taking, these things normally take time in the warehousing within.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.